Hey, welcome to Twinkle Tunes and Lighting. Today, we're going to take our Govees that are on our house that we just got for Thanksgiving, that we got for an early Christmas present, and we're going to control them with WLED. We're going to use a different controller. We're going to show you how, all the way from the beginning, of using your existing power with your existing lights, and you don't even have to cut them. That's right. Keep the warranty. It's good stuff. Stick around. I'll show you how to do it. All right, here's our list of items that we're gonna need. Number one, you're gonna need your power supply. So here's a 36 volt power supply. This is a replacement one for the Govees, but your house one will work, whichever one came with your stuff. So there's our 36 volt power supply. You're going to need a 12 volt DC pigtail like this one here, okay? That's the difference, it's a DC 12 volt pigtail. I went ahead and put some ends on it there. You're going to need some Govee extension cables. Okay, they sell these on Amazon. This one is from Monster Power or PWR, made in China. People are selling these all the time. You can get them anywhere out there, super cheap. But this way, we cut this up and we don't cut up our lights or cut up anything, so we don't void any of our warranties and stuff like that, okay? Third thing, you need your Govee lights. Okay, these are probably already installed in your house, but if they're not, you got a little strand hanging around, you can make sure all this works before you go put them up on your house. But if they are, here's your Govee lights. And then last but not least, the final thing, we need a controller. This is the best one that I think that is out there right now. This is the Bong 69 version 4, and it can take anywhere from 12 volts to 48 volts input into this controller. So we don't need any of those step downs, we don't need any of those buck converters, anything like that. So this is what we are going to be working with here. So let's clear off the table, and we're gonna go all the way from scratch, all the way to the end, and you guys are gonna see it work. All right, first let's start with our controller. We're gonna attach our controller to the 12 volt pigtails here. So our positive is gonna be the red side of the pigtail, and our negative is the black side of the pigtail, okay? So here we go, we're gonna put our pigtail right on here. Clearly it's not plugged in, because we are not gonna plug it in until we're ready to do that. So let's go ahead and terminate this one first. Here's our red one there. And you don't gotta over crank those at all, just get them nice and tight and call it good skis. If you ever crank them, you're gonna snap off that little solder joint that's holding those screws in, and you don't wanna do that, okay? Okay, here we go. Here is our negative side. Okay, we got our positive, our negative in. Let's just double check. Positive and negative, going all the way back. Okay, here we go, step two. Let's take our 36 volt power supply, which we have right here. We're gonna go plug that in to the outlet in your house, in your garage, wherever you are gonna be plugging it into. Now that I've got it plugged into the power, let's go ahead and power up our controller here. So here we go, fire this up, leap loop. And there we go. We got lights, we got power, we got blinky blinkies, everything's good, so we are ready to go. Now to just double check and make sure that is truly 36 volts, let's get out our handy dandy voltmeter here. Go to DC volts. Let's take a look and see if that is actually 36 volts, which I'm sure it is. Let's test this real quick. Got our positive on this side, negative on this side, and we're pulling up 35.8 volts. Okay, great. So we're cranking 36 volts, so we know that the power is gonna pass through here at 36 volts. So as we're working on this, we're gonna go ahead and unplug it, all right? Because we're gonna be start working on this. Next thing we need to do, we're gonna grab our extension, which we have here. Okay. And how the Govees work is that we are going to plug in to the female side. So we need the male side coming out of here. So male side going into the female side. So we're gonna take our extension. Let's look at it. We want that side right there. There's our male side right there. We're gonna come over here. We're gonna chop that end off. I'm gonna terminate it in here. So let's do that real quick. Okay, I've got that, and I've got that terminated now. On here, you're gonna see some lines of how it's all lined up. You're gonna see a dash, some words, and then one with no dash. On here, you're gonna see a dash, words, and no dash. When we plug this in, we wanna make sure that those are lining up, which they are, okay? Now, these are the Govee version ones, and the pros work the same way. Okay, the elites don't work like this. I'll show you that here in a second. Okay, so here's our dash, there's our line. Okay, your dash is your negative. Your middle is going to be your data, and your blank is going to be your positive. Okay, your dash is your negative, middle is your data, and the one without anything on it is going to be your positive. So once we got that terminated, you can see down on the board here that there's our negative data and our positive. There's our negative data and our positive. So now we are wired correctly. We're good on that. And we are going to go ahead and plug in our little board here. Now that we got our board plugged in, let's slide this down. Let's bring over our glob of Govees. And we're gonna go ahead and plug this in, and there we go. We are up, going, in no time. That looks great. And now we're gonna show you that it's actually being controlled by the app. We're gonna pull out the WLED app. And I've already synced this up to my WLED app. And here it is here. Here is our app. Here's our face. And here we go. There's our greens. There's our blue. There's our reds. How do I have it set up in here? You go to configure. I go to my LED preferences. I'm going to scroll down, and it is WS2811s. So WS2811s, WS2812s are the same. So you're going to go to the WS281X. And your order is RGB. And this one I think is like 15 long. So I put the length of 15. I hit save. And then we have control of our Govees. There they are. I mean, it can't get any better than that. Super easy, super simple. These are the Govee ones. And the other ones you can control are the Govee Pros. I haven't figured out the Elite yet, and I haven't figured out the Prisms. But if you have these, probably got them on sale. And if you got the Govee Pros, probably got those on sale too. So there you have it. Super simple, super easy. Convert your Govees over to a different app. Convert them over so you can use them in X-Lights, so that you can use them with Lidarama, so you can use them with any program, and get rid of that clunky app that they have. Simple project. Hey, thanks for watching. Hit the like, hit the subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one. That they'll do whatever you want them to do. Now I can tell them to do whatever I want. I make them any color I want to. I'm gonna make them whatever I want to do.